I'm Andy Howard, an Applications Engineer with Agilent ESOP EDA. ADS has a complete desktop flow for MMIC design, and load pull is one of the key steps if you are a power amplifier designer. I'm going to show you what the power and flexibility of ADS enable you to do for this application. ADS has design guides, examples, and templates that are pre-configured simulation setups and data displays. These enable you to utilize ADS's power as well as the knowledge of many expert users without having to figure out everything yourself from scratch. This is the first in a sequence of short videos and will include an overview and a one-tone load pull simulation demo. Subsequent videos will cover two-tone load pull, running load pull under batch mode, which enables you to see performance under many different conditions, and load pull with a WCDMA source. There are two basic ways of running load pull simulations. One is to hold the available source power constant and vary the load impedance. This will show how specifications, including the power delivered, vary as a function of the load. The other way is to specify that a specific power be delivered for all load impedances. Power amplifier designers usually want to use this second method because power delivered is the primary specification. Suppose you want to design a power amplifier that, while delivering a particular power to the load, minimizes the intermodulation distortion or minimizes the adjacent channel leakage ratio. How do you choose the best load reflection coefficient? How do other performance criteria like power added efficiency or gain compression vary with the load? This sort of investigation is often done with load pull measurement systems, but this can be time consuming. If you have access to a device model from a device modeler's work or a model from X-parameter measurements, either of which could be from a load pull measurement system, you may run a load pull simulation using the model, saving you a lot of time and effort. How do we run constant power delivered load pull simulations in ADS? We vary the load in some region of the Smith chart, and for each load we adjust via an optimization the available source power until the desired power is delivered. In post-processing, we generate contours for different performances of interest. In ADS, the easiest way to access these load pull simulation setups is to select Design Guide, Load Pull. This brings up a load pull window, and we'll select one tone constant power delivered load pull simulation. After clicking OK, a schematic and data display are copied into our project. To use this schematic to run a load pull simulation on your device, you would delete the sample device and its model. You would adjust the bias voltages appropriately. You'd specify the center and radius of the circular region on the Smith chart over which the loads will be swept. You'd set the source frequency, and you'd set the harmonic impedances at the load and also at the source. For this sample device, I've increased the number of points from 64 to 144, and I click the optimization icon to start the simulation. What you see here is the single optimizable variable, the available source power, being adjusted up and down such that we deliver the desired power to the load for each of the different load reflection coefficients. The data display shows contours of constant gain and gain compression, as well as contours of constant power added efficiency and bias current. These lines are the input reflection coefficient as the load is varied. The boxes to the left show, for example, what the maximum PAE load is, what that value is, and what the corresponding other performances are, as well as this box here, which shows the minimum gain compression point. These boxes on the left show the clear trade-off between power added efficiency and gain compression. At the maximum power added efficiency load, you get about 31% power added efficiency. The gain compression, however, is close to 5 dB. If you can tolerate a lower power added efficiency, say 20.7%, then you can get much lower gain compression and a much higher gain of 17 dB. To the left of the boxes are plots of the voltage and current in the device, and these are useful to determine over what fraction of the cycle the device is conducting, as well as to see what the peak amplitudes are. This first video in a sequence on constant power delivered load pull simulation has given an overview as well as some details concerning one-tone load pull simulations. We have shown how ADS makes it easy for you to pick the optimal load or make trade-offs to meet your requirements. Please view the subsequent videos on two-tone, batch, and WCDMA load pull simulations. Please visit our website for information about the latest release of ADS. Supported customers not yet using ADS 2009 Update 1 may download an ADS 2008 version of this example from our Knowledge Center.